the plan. Sean?
Yeah, Joe, Micah, that shooting on February 15th not only changed that one officer's life, but the lives of so many others.
179 days ago, Illinois' second largest city was brought to its knees.
We've got an active shooter, 641 Archer, 641 Archer Avenue.
A shooting inside of Aurora's venerable Henry Pratt Company, the gunman, an employee about to be terminated.
As police officers, our main focus was we have to get in that building.
Marco Gomez was one of the officers to run toward the gunfire, arriving just 4 minutes from the first 911 call. He is one of the five officers injured in that 90-minute standoff.
As we were walking through the silence, the eerie, we didn't hear any gunshots. We didn't hear anybody screaming. Then you hear the gunshots, and you start looking around and see where they're coming from. I did not see him, but I did see where the shots were coming from. I saw the door, the glass in the door start shattering. I could see the bullets or the rounds kind of impacting on the ground next to me, so I knew where they were coming from.
That's the thing that you prepare for. We were prepared that day.
In the 6 months since the shooting, Police Chief Kristen Zeman has looked over her department. Recently, she was given these photos. The photos snapped by a sergeant as decisions were made that day.
It brings back the emotion when I look at it. I remember feeling the emotion, but when I look at it again, it all just kind of comes right back, the feeling of being there.
And behind her desk is this small yellow list, one of the many she received that day, but this one was special, putting names for the first time to the five victims who perished in that February shooting. The national headlines have since moved on to other locations: Virginia Beach, Gilroy, California, El Paso, and Dayton.
It's the thing that happens that you don't think is going to happen in your jurisdiction under your watch. And despite the preparation, it's still unbelievable to me that our name is on that list.
What is to be believed, they say, is the transformation this department, this city, has made.
It's really amazing how closer we have come as a police department, how closer I've been with my family, how closer the community's been with the police department, how closer the community is with each other. And I think that, again, it's a credit to the community. When something bad happens, you're either going to fall or you're going to rise up. And I think our community, the city of Aurora has really, they rised up to the occasion. We've become closer, and it's just better.
Only one of the five officers injured on that February shooting is now back full-time at the police department. Officer Gomez not quite there. He was shot in the hip. He is hopeful, though, to return to the department soon, 100%. As far as Thursday is concerned, there will be counselors here at the police department to talk with officers and other events happening to commemorate the six-month mark for this shooting here in Aurora. That's the latest here live in Aurora tonight. Sean Lewis, WGN News.